Smiling, apparently, is good for you.
It is. You should try it sometime. You feel great.
Well, you normally smile because you're happy.
Smiling a lot can be what makes you happy in the first place.
You could say it's the ultimate goal in life, to be happy. And we all have different ways of putting a smile on our faces. A smile is a sign of happiness, but could it also be a cause of happiness?
Some psychologists believe that by forcing our face into a smile, we can make ourselves feel happy.
So is there a link between our facial expressions and the way we feel? We're going to test this theory with the help of two sets of volunteers.
Now, they don't know it yet, but we're planning to make this group feel happy and make this group feel sad.
To do this, we've enlisted the help of comedian Geoff Whiting and a large quantity of pens.
I can't cope with that. How am I going to...
Geoff will perform the same five-minute comedy routine in front of both groups. And the pens, well, we're going to use them in a rather strange way.
Diet dog food.
I'm going to ask the first group to keep a pen between their lips like this. The second group will be asked to hold the pen lengthways in their mouth while they watch the same routine.
Hopefully they won't dribble too much.
Overseeing the experiment is psychologist Professor Richard Wiseman. It sounds odd, but according to the professor, the position of the pen in the mouth could have a big effect on how much they enjoyed the comedy.
...in Britain than teenagers. This is a new statistic. There are now more old age pensioners than teenagers, and apparently if all the old people in Britain stood in a long line, nobody else would ever get served.
The volunteers are asked the school how much they like the routine.
Call Sean Connery, though.
Some bits were funny, but yeah, he was all right.
Some of the jokes were okay, but not particularly great.
Average, I would say. I give 6 out of 10.
So our first group weren't too impressed with our funny man's jokes. Will he fare any better with audience number 2?
Unlike English people you see on those adverts for insurance companies, have you seen these? You get rewarded for being rubbish, don't you? Have you seen? I saw one recently. A bloke walked forward to the camera and said, I spilt a bucket of hot tar on my arms. I got £12,000. He should have got the sack.
I thought it was brilliant.
Yeah, it was all right.
I spit my pen out on the floor nearly, so I go...
It kept us entertained.
It's not one of these people that tend to laugh, but I actually found it quite funny.
Frankly, to my amazement, the group who were smiling more really did seem to enjoy it more. What's happening?
Well, in one condition, the people were having their faces forced into a smile, and the other forced into a frown. So without realising it, those two facial expressions made them feel happier or a little bit sadder, and then that actually influenced how funny they found the comedy.
We've seen the results. What about the science behind it? What's going on?
This is what's called the facial feedback hypothesis, the idea that we force our face into an expression that actually directly influences the brain. So here we force our face into a smile that forces the brain to release endorphins, which actually makes us feel good.
That they say the same thing to all the
This
customers.
Experiment shows how we can physically manipulate our bodies to produce hormones that make us feel happy.
Yes, happiness really is more than a subjective mood. It's real, and it can be measured.
Because it's real, there are physical things you can do that'll help make you feel happier. Eating properly, taking exercise, and keeping in touch with friends are ways in which we can all look after our mental health.
Now, I'm not suggesting that smiling more is a cure for all life's problems. But anything that makes you feel happier, even in a small way, could be worth a try.
Thank you very much indeed for your attention. I'm Geoff Whiting. Good afternoon. People should smile.